All right, so on today's little mini lesson, we are going to start talking about force tension in a string with two blocks and a pulley system. The one we're going to look at today has one mass on a flat horizontal table, the other is hanging down. So what we are looking at is block like that, 1.50 kilograms, mass one. Mass 2 and 0.70 kilograms. Okay, so we have mass 1 and mass 2. Now it's important to note that friction in this problem, we are not going to use friction. So this is a frictionless pulley and a frictionless surface. Not really happening in reality, but for this problem, we're going to set it that way. So we need to make free body diagrams of each mass to determine exactly what the force tension is going to equal. So if we look at mass one, we have a force normal and a force gravity in opposite directions. And then we have a force tension going that way. Which means that if the force tension is going this way and the string is pulling down, remember the force tension has to go up that way in the opposite direction for the force of gravity in this part of the problem. So when we look at mass two, we have force tension up and force of gravity down. Now at this point, I'm gonna say FG1 and FG2. So we've got our two free body diagrams. We know roughly what's going on here. Now, if we took this mass right here and we brought it up and they were on the same horizontal plane, that would mean that the tension on this side would be going this way and the tension on this side would be going that way. So we need to set our direction so we understand when the system is moving, which way is positive, which way is negative. So we're gonna say that moving to the right is positive. Now, at this point in time, we can start to solve for the acceleration of the system. And if we know the acceleration of the system, we can find the force tension as all forces are equal to mass times acceleration. So we're going to say that force is equal to mass times acceleration. Now it's important to note that this system has a combined mass, but the force is only equal to the force of gravity on the second object because the force of gravity on the first object cancels out. Force normal is the same as force of gravity on this object, meaning it does not contribute. If you had an inclined plane where there was object going like this and an object going like that, you would have to take into consideration FG1 in this calculation. However, in this case, it's just FG2. So FG2 equals M times A and is solely responsible for the acceleration of this system. And it's important to note that we should also say mass total for this system. So M2G is equal to mass total A. We know MG2 because M2G, we know M2, we know G, and we know the mass total. So we can solve for A. A equals M2G all over MT. Now, it's also important to note that I did not put my numbers in yet. I rearranged without putting in my numbers just so that I know I'm doing the proper mathematics. Now I'm gonna throw my numbers in. 0.700, 9.8, 0.700, plus 1.5. That's zero. Now this will equal 3.1 meters a second. Now notice significant figures, 9.8, 3.1, two digits. So the acceleration of this entire system is 3.1 meters a second, right there. Now, if we went back to our free body diagram, we said that Fn, Fg1, and Ft, and this is our mass one. Now remember, we have an acceleration equal to 3.1 meters a second squared in that direction. So the force of tension is equal to this acceleration in terms of the fact that we would use this, because it's in the same direction, to find our force tension. So force tension equals m times a, but this is the mass of the block here. This is the mass of m1, which is 1.5. The tension equals 4.7 newtons in this string. Now we want to fact check this. We want to see, did we do this right? So if we did it right, let's put right up here, force tension equals 4.7 newtons. Did this right, that's our force tension on, this side. If the force tension on this side is negative 4.7 newtons because it's going upwards in the opposite direction, then both the tensions are equal and they are good. Equal magnitude but opposite direction. So if we go back to M2, force net equals Fg2 plus force tension. So we're solving for force tension. So F net minus Fg2 equals force tension. Force tension equals mass 2 times acceleration minus mass 2 times g. We sub in our masses. Subtract, and we go. So -4.7 newtons, opposite direction, equal magnitude. We are good. All right, so that's how you solve for a force tension question with two masses and a pulley and no friction.